Up here in the Northern Hemisphere, we're moving relentlessly towards that time of year when millions of householders reluctantly switch their home heating systems back on. For most people, that means keeping their fingers crossed that their gas combi boiler hasn't seized up over the summer and that it will actually fire back into life without incident. For many, it will signal time for the annual service, which in some cases will bring unwelcome news about the boiler's health and projected remaining lifetime. For other unfortunate folks, switching the system back on may even reveal that their boiler has given up the ghost completely, prompting a decision about how best to replace it. Until recently, that process was generally a straightforward cost-benefit analysis of the latest gas boiler options on the market, often with the help and advice of a trained heating engineer. But of course, these newfangled electric heat pumps have come on the scene now, haven't they? And we've heard that they're like 3 or 4 times more efficient than gas boilers, and that they avoid all those carbon dioxide emissions that we keep getting told are warming up the planet. So a growing number of people are asking their heating engineer whether a heat pump might be the right option to replace their old gas boiler. And here's where many of us hit a brick wall. Because through absolutely no fault of their own, modern heating engineers have in most cases become highly specialised at just fitting gas combi boilers and have had no training whatsoever on heat pumps. So it's hardly surprising that a large number of householders are being told that a heat pump is not suitable for their home and that a nice quick and easy boiler replacement is the best option. But now, thanks to some extremely smart boffins and a very decent dollop of algorithmic artificial intelligence, all that is about to change. Hello, and welcome to Just Have a Think. The technology I'm referring to comes from a UK company called HeatGeek, who I'm sure will already be well known to many of you good folks watching this video. Now, for full disclosure, I do know the folks at HeatGeek, and I have spoken to them at some length as part of the research for this video, but they're not sponsoring the video or paying me in any way to talk about their latest technological breakthrough. I'm talking about it because I think it's very good stuff indeed, simple as that. In fact, what HeatGeek has come up with are a couple of technologies, both of which are designed to address the brick wall of objections that so many households appear to be running into these days when they ask about heat pumps. Before we get to those solutions, though, it's worth properly understanding the perceived problems. Problem number one, historical oversizing of heating systems. Back when gas prices were as low as 3 pence per unit, and nobody had ever heard of greenhouse gas emissions or global warming, there was absolutely no reason or incentive whatsoever for a heating engineer to meticulously calculate the precise heating requirements of each individual home they visited. It was enough just to have a quick look around the property, do a rough mental calculation, increase that guesstimate by maybe 1.5 or 2 times just to be on the safe side, and recommend a heating system that was invariably far larger than the house needed. But it didn't matter, did it? Because the fuel was dirt cheap, the installations were quick and relatively unobtrusive, and as long as the customer could get hot water and warm rooms on demand, everyone was happy. So how is that a problem then, Dave? Well, it is a problem if you start applying those same vague guesstimates to an electric heat pump system, which is what's happening in many cases today. Because heat pumps warm a home up in a completely different way to a gas-fired boiler system. Essentially, they provide a low and slow, constantly comfortable temperature rather than waiting for the house to get really cold and then blasting it with a gas flame that makes the radiators so hot you can't actually touch them. Add to that the obscene market distortions that incorrectly inflate the cost of a unit of domestic electricity to 3 or 4 times more than a unit of domestic gas, and it suddenly becomes vitally important to get the space heating calculations absolutely bob on for each individual home, so that we customers aren't paying over the odds for a heat pump installation in the first place, and so we can achieve running costs that are the same or even slightly lower than we got for our old boilers. And that is something that, again, through no fault of their own, most modern heating engineers are simply not trained to do. Problem number two, where to put a great big water cylinder? When combi boilers became popular back in the 1990s, one of their many selling points was the fact that they were small. For most people, that meant a large space became available where their water cylinder used to be. As a result, lots more people had a new shower cubicle or a kitchen extension or whatever. The point is, the space was generally repurposed for something useful. Now heat pumps have come along and we're being told we've got to put water cylinders back in where there's no longer a convenient space for them to go in our house. Or maybe you live in a flat like millions of other people in the country and there was never a space for a large water cylinder in the first place. All those issues have resulted in people up and down the country either being told a heat pump is impossible for them or getting crazy quotes for installations that, even with the £7,500 government incentive payment, still come out far more expensive than a traditional gas combi. To address all those issues, the folks at HeatGeek, led by a highly experienced and uniquely visionary plumbing and heating engineer called Adam Chapman, started a program to train hundreds of new and existing tradespeople to become extremely knowledgeable and highly competent experts in designing and installing correctly sized heat pump systems all over the United Kingdom. Now, plenty of companies would have settled at that point and congratulated themselves on a job well done. But not the guys at HeatGeek. They also developed proprietary LiDAR room scanning heat loss software, a world's first at the time, by the way, to analyse the heat loss of each room in much more detail than ever possible before. With those tools in their armoury, since 2023, the company has analysed data on roughly 80,000 properties across the UK, visited more than 3,500 of those homes, and gathered millions of real-world data points. That's obviously been very helpful indeed for their highly skilled engineers in providing more accurate calculations for their customers. But even that wasn't good enough for a team whose goal was to weed out inefficiency at every stage of the heat pump design and implementation process. So each new installation was connected via an interface to HeatGeek's central system, which monitored the ongoing performance of thousands of different data points every 15 minutes of every day. Then they used that enormous data set to create a complex algorithmic artificial intelligence system that they call Zero Disrupt. So how does that help efficiency then? Well, it means that instead of an engineer spending hours and hours working through all the unique variables of every single property and doing all the calculations to work out what kind of system each customer requires, they can now simply load the dimensions and fabric of a building into the Zero Disrupt AI system, and it will output the optimal combination of efficiency, installation price, and running costs tailored precisely to a customer's home. And here's the thing, when they were testing the system, the HeatGeek team found that these types of highly tailored installations required less than a third of the adaptations and changes that typically come as a result of manual calculations. And that's because there are just so many subtle variations and tiny nuances that are unique to each property, all of which can interact in any number of different ways to amplify or nullify various outcomes, that it'd be impossible for a human being, however well trained, to factor every single one of them into their calculations. But of course, that's precisely the sort of thing that artificial intelligence was built for, isn't it? The guys at HeatGeek say their Zero Disrupt system designs for a guaranteed efficiency. Guaranteed because if it ever fails to deliver optimum efficiency, which has apparently never happened yet, but if it ever did, then the HeatGeek team will revisit the customer's home to carry out whatever works are necessary to reach that level free of charge. It is unsurprisingly called the HeatGeek Guarantee. And at the time of publishing this video, HeatGeek are the only UK heating company offering such a comprehensive backup. Their CEO, Adil Qureshi, explained that their customers can now have systems installed that keep their home warm all year round for the same running cost as their old boiler. Or if they're on a heat pump tariff from their electricity provider, they can potentially achieve savings of around £400 a year. Plus, because customers no longer find themselves having to replace 10 radiators, which was actually the average swap out rate on previous heat pump installations, the system cost once the government grant has been applied is working out on an average of £3,000, which is comparable to a new gas boiler installation. And in some cases, the net quote has literally worked out at zero cost. In other words, the whole system, supplied and installed, has cost no more than the £7,500 grant provided by the UK government. Oh yeah, and of course, if you do give a hoot about the climate, you can take comfort in the knowledge that you will be avoiding as much as 45,000 kilograms of carbon dioxide emissions over the typical 15 to 20 year lifespan of a system. But you still need to shoehorn a large water cylinder in somewhere, don't you? Well, not necessarily. The heat geek bods have addressed that limitation as well. A typical large water cylinder in a heat pump system has a heat exchanger coil inside it that carries hot water from the heat pump. The coil transfers that heat into the cylinder water, which can then be used for your washing up or your shower or bath or whatever. Because water expands when it heats up, there also has to be an expansion vessel located somewhere nearby. And regulations say there needs to be a pressure relief valve connected via 22mm copper pipe that has to be routed to the outside of the building. All a bit of a faff, not to mention all the space it takes up. Adam and his colleagues at HeatGeek have completely upended that design with a cylinder that they call the mini store. Instead of running hot water from the heat pump through the heat exchanger coil, the mini store runs that hot water straight into the main body of the cylinder and then lets it heat up the household water, which now runs through the coil and back out into the home. Sounds like a very simple swap around, doesn't it? But it means the cylinder can be shrunk down to a size that can be fitted inside a kitchen base unit. Why? Well, because the cylinder can now be reloaded much more rapidly at the full power capacity of the heat pump, but running at a lower temperature, because the hot water is no longer restricted by the small diameter of the copper pipe. And because the water storage volume is now below a crucial industry threshold of 16 litres, the mini store cylinder no longer requires an additional expansion vessel, and there's no need for a pressure relief valve and all that large pipe work that has to be run to the outside of the building. Plus, as an added bonus, there's no need to run a weekly anti-legionella cycle, because the consumable water only flows in and out of the heat exchange coil as and when it's required, which means you save on that additional weekly running cost as well. In other words, the whole thing runs much more like a combi boiler, and there's no problem fitting it into tight spaces in the house or a flat. HeatGeek also told me that they're now trialling a product that's a third of the size of their mini store. They're calling it the Nano Store, and it'll apparently be smaller than the smallest combi boiler on the market. That product will be stress tested over this winter and launched in early 2026. Does it all sound a bit too good to be true? Well, no one's suggesting that the laws of thermodynamics are being broken here, but they're certainly being applied in a much smarter way. If you want to see a real-world example in action, then you can click up there somewhere or follow the link in the description below to a more comprehensive video explainer at HeatGeek's own YouTube channel. I've had a heat pump in my house for about 4 years now, and it has performed flawlessly for all that time, keeping my house at 20 degrees Celsius 24/7, 365. But I'm quite sure it would have been an even more efficient system if it had been designed using HeatGeek's new Zero Disrupt AI tool. And I did have to move my fridge to make room for a large water cylinder. So HeatGeek's new mini store cylinder, or the even newer Nano Store, would have been a great option for me too. I reckon HeatGeek have come up with a couple of great solutions here to overcome objections and barriers to heat pump installations. But it'd be great to know what you think. Could the Zero Disrupt AI and mini store cylinders tip the balance in your decision making? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. But that's it for this week. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed this video. And if you also click on all notifications, you'll get a ping when new videos drop every Sunday. And you can also directly support my work by joining the fabulous group of individuals over at patreon.com/justhaveathink. Most important of all, though, thanks very much for watching. Have a great week, and remember to just have a think. See you next week.